Hannah Baker reporting from the American Diabetes Association Scientific Sessions, the largest diabetes meeting in the world. Here in Philadelphia, we've got more good news about the safety of using daily insulin. For years, people have debated whether there are adverse consequences to long-term insulin use. But yesterday, researchers reported that daily insulin injections, when begun during the early stages of type 2 diabetes, neither increased or reduced the risk of heart attacks, strokes, cancer, or cardiovascular-related deaths. Referred to as Origin, this particular study is the largest and longest of its kind. It looked at more than 12,500 patients at high risk for or in the early stages of type 2 diabetes. Participants were randomly assigned to either receive a daily injection of glargine insulin or standard care without insulin over a period of several years. Researchers found no difference among the two groups in cardiovascular outcomes or in the development of any type of cancer, suggesting that daily insulin injections to control blood glucose levels are not harmful when taken over long periods of time. The study did confirm two previously known side effects of insulin, hypoglycemia, which is low blood glucose, and modest weight gain. However, both of these were minor. The study also examined whether daily insulin used in people at high risk for type 2 diabetes would prevent or slow the progression of the disease. And the good news is that it did. Those who received daily insulin injections had a 28% lower chance of developing type 2 diabetes even after the injections were stopped, compared to those who were not given any insulin whatsoever. The researchers think that this is because giving insulin to people with somewhat elevated blood glucose levels allows the pancreas to rest, essentially helping it to work longer. Insulin was first used to treat diabetes 90 years ago, and now thanks to this new research, we can now say that the risk of taking insulin on a long-term basis are low. Not only that, but it can prevent or delay type 2 diabetes in high-risk patients. One more note for those of you who might be interested in omega-3 fatty acids. Investigators also looked at whether giving people with type 2 diabetes daily doses of omega-3 could help prevent cardiac-related deaths. They actually saw no effect, good or bad. I'm Anna Baker reporting from the American Diabetes Association's Scientific Sessions in Philadelphia. To view this press release online, please visit the For Media section of our website. And for the latest breaking news and research from Scientific Sessions, stay tuned to diabetes.org/breakingnews.